When's your mom leaving for Australia?
Oh, in about an hour and a half. I'm getting rid of her for 2 whole months, you guys. I can go to the beach. I can stay out as late as I want to. I can do anything.
How come you gotta go?
Because I've had a very rough 37 years, and I need a break.
You haven't taken out the trash in weeks, and the lawn needs mowing, and your room looks like a disaster.
Hey!
Why did you leave your dishes in the sink for me? God, you take these things so personally.
Yeah. Love, you live there.
The dishwasher's full, okay?
So empty it.
That's Kenny's job.
Kenny!
I'll do it later, Mom! I promise!
Relax, Mom. Everything's gonna be great when you're gone.
Hello to you. I'm Mrs. Durack. I'm the babysitter.
What?
Is that the babysitter?
There's plenty of money in here for groceries and some spending money for the kids.
I can't believe you're doing this to me. A babysitter?
I couldn't leave you kids all alone. You're not capable of running the show while I'm gone. You're not an adult yet.
Be good, everybody! Bye!
Bye!
All right, you little maggots, now line up. Time to go over the rules.
I'm sorry?
Now move!
I don't know what your deal is, but you're not here to order us around.
Cooperate, or I'll make your summer a living hell!
What did they do, summon Hitler from hell?
I was watching that!
TV rots your brains.
Is she possessed or something?
Time for little boys to be in bed.
We've got to get rid of the old lady.
Why are you guys wearing name tags?
She says she has trouble remembering things.
I really don't think I can live like this. Okay, I'll talk to her.
Mrs. Sturek!
Look, Mrs. Sturek, we have decided that we're not going to take any more of your crap, okay? Now, first of all, the name tags have got to go. Mrs. Sturek, are you even listening to me? Mr. Eck? Mr. Eck? Mr. Eck? Will?
Okay, she didn't wake up. She fell on the floor.
We didn't want you to send her to the glue factory.
I didn't kill her, Zach. She died in her sleep.
What should we do with her body?
Call an ambulance? Call the cops? I don't know. They'll definitely call Mom.
She'll hop the next flight home and then she'll be in our faces.
I don't want Mom to come home.
I don't either.
What? Do you guys hate your mother?
Sure she's gonna fit?
How the hell should I know? I've never done this before.
Well, neither have I.
I mean, we're saving the ambulance people a trip, right? I mean, when they find her, they'll take care of everything.
Okay, I take issue with the word nice.
Bobby.
We're out of food. I'm going marketing.
You're taking Mrs. Sturek's car?
Life goes on. I mean, come on. This car's a classic.
You're stealing the old lady's car? It's not your car.
I think that she'd want it this way.
No.
Don't you?
She didn't want to die.
There's no money in here.
Yes, there is. I saw Mom give it to Mrs. Sturek.
Well, she must have taken it out.
Maybe the old lady had the money in her pocket. Did you check there? Oh no, you can't.
What are we gonna do for cash for the next 2 months?
One of us has to get a job.
Well, I'm not gonna.
We'll flip for it. Mama Celeste, face up. I go to work. Okay, I'll get a job.
You gotta put chili on those clown dogs and keep it moving.
Put on a happy face.
Shit.
What are you doing?
Not your dream job, huh?
Got that right. My mom's out of town for a while, and I have my brothers and sister to feed.
You forgot one very big thing. Forgot to put on a happy face.
Finish the happy fat fats yourself. I'm here for the receptionist job.
Is this your resume?
Yeah.
Wow. Whoa, girl. Those were some hefty lies.
This is fabulous.
Thank you.
They're looking for a receptionist to replace Carol. And she's supposed to move up to be my executive administrative assistant. I can't stand her. You be my assistant, and I'll just tell him I hired outside the company.
Yeah, see, this is why you don't lie on your resume, at least not to this extent.
Please say yes.
Yes, when do I get paid?
1st and 15th of every month. This is my new administrative assistant, Sue Ellen. Sue Ellen, this is Gus Brandon, vice president
of
marketing. And he serves me breakfast in bed.
Only when she deserves it.
Oh. Miss Creep has entered the chat.
I'm Rose Lindsay, Senior Vice President of Operations.
I have my own office, and I have a great view.
What's the job?
I am the Executive Administrative Assistant to the Senior Vice President of Operations.
What the hell is that?
I don't know.
That's our car!
Let's go, let's go!
Hey, what are you queens doing in our car?
Shit!
Now how are we gonna get home?
Hi, thanks for coming.
No problem.
I'm sorry if I acted like a bitch the other night at Clown Dog. I was walking out like that.
Yeah. I'm glad you called, really.
Yeah, me too.
Wanna go to the beach and watch the Grunion run Monday night?
You mean a date?
Yeah, a date.
Yeah, sure.
Excuse me, where do you think you're going?
To Rose Lindsay's office. I work for her now.
You?
I'm Sue Ellen.
This is our new spring line.
Lovely, isn't it?
Yeah, lovely.
This is Franklin, our head designer.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
This is the QED report. I've made some notes in it. See if you can make a dent after lunch. Oh, and fax this to New York for me.
Where did that come from?
I had it delivered. Do you have a problem with that? My little brother drives the delivery van.
Oh, no. Oh, fudge.
Rose's new executive administrative assistant. You're swamped.
Yeah. Are you familiar with the QED report?
Really?
Yeah, go ahead. Really.
Thank you.
And you're going to do a cake. You really have to have a battle plan already so that when you start in, you can just go right through the cake.
Bye. Oh, Kathy, thank you so much.
By the way, you can cash personal checks for our employees.
Guard it with your life and just leave receipts for whatever you take. I'll authorize it, okay?
I have been working. I've had a very rough day.
What is your problem?
You couldn't even mow the lawn today. You're worthless. When are you gonna start helping me, you lazy little punk?
You going to college or what?
I'm supposed to register at City College. What about you?
My parents want me to go to UCSD. Yeah, but I'm not so sure.
It's like once you decide on something, it's all planned out.
Yeah, it's like all of a sudden anything that you do means that that's your life.
Then you're stuck in this plan because you decided, you know?
Kenny, the food that I bought yesterday is already gone.
I was entertaining some friends last night, and we had the munchies.
I would kick him out of the house.
Go buy some more food for the kids.
All right, you got paid.
Well, not exactly. It's office money. It's called petty cash.
I need to get this PO approved.
Okay.
I got a real good deal on some materials.
Yeah, good.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi. Hungry?
No, dude!
How long have you and Rose been together?
A few months. We agreed we're not exclusive. Do people always tell you how young you look?
No, not usually.
Have a drink. It's a special occasion.
What's the special occasion?
It's our first lunch together.
What, of many?
And by the end of lunch, we'll probably be sharing our intimate histories.
Ew, no.
Next thing you know, we'll be sharing a cigarette in post-coital bliss.
Are you talking about us having sex?
Hey, hold on, slow down. You're moving too fast for me. Rosemary chicken's delicious here. Very tender.
Oh, I am getting just like top level creepiness from this guy.
Thank you for lunch.
Anytime.
Ew.
Now she's kissing up to Gus. I can't stand that conniving little snot.
I just don't think that kids are going to want to wear uniforms.
It's not up to the students to decide.
I don't know. I mean, kids like to wear stuff that's them.
Gus has been trying to talk me into this wild, dirty weekend in Santa Barbara, and I really want to go.
So I'll pick you up at work around, what, 6?
No. Don't do that.
Swell, what's going on?
Nothing.
Okay, well, then why won't you tell me where you work?
I just don't want you to know, okay?
I mean, are you seeing someone else? I mean, that's what it sounds like.
No, there is nobody else, okay? I just wish that you could respect my privacy, that's all.
I'm out of here.
Please don't. Ew. That's...
Oh. Oh, you got roses. And who might they be from?
No. They're for you.
Obviously, our weekend away in Santa Barbara was the turning point for us.
I stole her resume from personnel. Checked her out. None of these companies ever heard of her. I'm going to Rose.
She's not gonna care. You've got to get something better on her than that.
This is a QED report, I promised. So Ellen, I'd do it for her. Could you see that she gets it? It's really important. Thanks.
Thank you.
So Ellen, where have you been? Where's the QED report?
I have that for you, Rose.
What are you doing with it?
Kathy Henderson brought it by. Seems she's been covering for Sue Ellen, doing her work for her.
Bravo, you really know how to delegate responsibility. Carolyn, you want to be executive material? Keep an eye on Sue Ellen.
My check is only for $735.
I thought you were getting like over a grand.
Taxes. They took half of my money away for taxes.
Where'd this come from?
Japan.
Where'd you get the money for something so state-of-the-art?
Well, it was petty cash money.
How could you do this? There's only $30 left. You have spent over $3,000?
$3,000?
How could you steal from me? I am in deep shit.
GAW's history. We're all gonna be out of a job.
What?
The students got wind of it last night and held a huge protest. We're probably all gonna be canned tomorrow.
I have an idea. Sue Ellen.
This is gonna save our collective asses. It's fabulous.
I want this place spick and span by Saturday night or I'm turning us all in.
But the recipe calls for shrimp, so I need some more cash.
There's nothing left in petty cash. I've taken it all.
Oh, my God, no.
I'm stuck here cooking and cleaning and mowing, helping Melissa with her fastball, being a role model for Zach.
Okay, what's the problem?
You've got the car and you don't even take me anywhere anymore.
It's a rat race and it sucks, Kenny.
I knew she was a phony. I did not think she was a thief.
She's only 17.
Where's Kenny?
Wow.
Good evening, Mrs. Crandall.
Kenny, you look great.
All right, everyone, man your trays. Get going there. Better get your ass out there, Mrs. Crandall.
Rose, this is my daughter, Melissa.
Hey, boss lady, Creole mushroom.
Oh, hello, Melissa. No, thanks, not tonight. I love that they're wearing our uniforms. Fabulous touch.
Swell, take the baked brie out of the oven, it'll caramelize.
He's found his profession for sure.
Since this is the biggest night in GAW history, I thought you might like to know that this all rests in the hands of a child.
This is by far and away the most petty, spiteful, vindictive machination you have ever.
I am loving this boss.
Grow up, Carolyn.
We're here. What do you want us to do?
Hi.
Oh, great.
No, I know you said you're not interested.
That's right. No, not.
I understand why. My timing is off. And
Dude, she's 17.
Gus, you can't imagine how off your timing is.
Or we could just have a wild, sweaty fling. What do you think?
What is wrong with this man? Ew.
Gus has sort of a little crush on me.
He's been coming on to you?
You know how I feel about you. You're the one I want to listen to beautiful music with.
Right.
So, Ellen, it's showtime. Okay.
Good evening.
Please make it go well, please.
I'd like to introduce to you our hostess, our recently named Employee of the Month, and the woman responsible for all you're going to view tonight, Sue Ellen Crandall.
We're approaching the millennium with a fresh attitude and a fresh look. And what we have for you tonight is a preview of the General Apparel West to come. Nicole is wearing a Form 3 nurse's uniform with mini hemline, sure to speed up any boy's pulse.
Please don't tell me he's gonna be the one ruining all this.
Mom's home.
I lied to everyone about everything. I'm only 17. I have a curfew. I just finished high school. I can't even vote yet. I can't be the hub of your communication network. Rose, I'm so sorry.
I specifically said no parties.
I have had a very rough night. So why don't you just go upstairs and take a nap, and tomorrow morning Kenny will whip up a batch of Belgian waffles and we'll sit down and discuss this like adults, all right?
See what happens when you calm down and listen?
I'll be damned.
Rose, I am so sorry.
Byers didn't care anything about that scene. They loved your ideas. You see nothing but dollar signs. As a matter of fact, they complimented me on hiring a teenager to gain market perspective.
But what about everything else? I mean, I lied to you.
I suppose you'll grow out of that.
Maybe.
I got a date with Swell's friend, Nicole. The nurse? Yeah. Right.
Hey, you know, school starts next week. Lazy days.
I don't know. I was thinking I might go to class more.
All right, Kenny, you're redeeming yourself.
You know, I might take some home ec. Maybe go to the Culinary Academy or some shit like that.
Yeah, you're good at it.
I think I'm gonna try college. Design school or something, I don't know. I still have a lot to learn, you know?
Oh, if you want to get into Vassar, I could pull some strings.
Maybe.
Let's get together Monday night. We'll have dinner, okay?
Okay.
So, what are you doing New Year's Eve?
One more thing.
Yeah, Mom?
Where is the babysitter?
Yeah, we didn't really address that issue. Let's talk about it. Alright, that was me watching Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter is Dead. It was a sweet film. It was like this feel-good film, this cliche film, but it was a good plot. It was unlike any other films that I've seen so far. I mean, it wasn't romantic, but it wasn't really comedy. It was a nice film. I give it like 3 out of 5. The plot made sense, everything worked out in the end. Yeah, I liked it. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. And also, if you want to give me suggestions, you can just comment down below or you can check out the social media links. They're all in the description box. I'll see you in the next video.